Meet my friend Amanda Dinello. This is her testimony of how Jesus set her free.
This is the spot where I found healing after all my trauma. It's Chapman's Landing in Indian Head, Maryland. And across the river here, we can see DC and Virginia. And the sun's about to set, so we're going to take you guys with us so you can see the beautiful
morning. Wow. Amanda, is there any verse that comes to mind right now that you want to share with the viewers?
I will never leave you nor forsake you, because at one point I thought God did abandon me. And so when I come here and I see a beautiful creation that God had and has, it reminds me that He's with me always, and I can carry Him in my heart. He's closer than my own self to myself. He's inside of me. So, yeah.
Wow.
That's what comes to mind.
And what specifically were you working through when you first came back here?
I was deceived by someone who claimed to be from God, and she said that she had a ministry for the kingdom of God, and that they were gonna start building for the end times, for all the tribulation that's supposed to come. And so I lacked a lot of knowledge, and no one discipled me in this sense. There's people who discipled me, but we all parted ways after years. So after that, I didn't have anybody to take me under their wing, and I was brand new to the faith. And so she coerced me into believing that I needed to leave family, friends, work, material things, give her all my money. And it was much like a cult.
Wow.
And so I left everything to follow this lady. And within a couple months, I was forced to go without food, without sleep. And I was panhandling for a year. And there's tons
wow.
of other just monstrosities that she made me do, but there was a lot of trauma from this situation because I was with her for a year, and
and you wrote a book. Can you share with people where that book is found so they can read the whole testimony?
Sure can. I, like Kaylee said, I wrote a book, and I wrote it for the reason that there's way more details to the story about how I got involved with that and how did I get out of that and what happened during that time. There's a lot of questions from people, and I didn't have enough time in a conversation to tell them the depth of what was going on. And so I wrote this book, but I also wrote another part of, like, in another part of the story, it talks about my heroin addiction that I had prior to that.
Wow.
And I overdosed close to 20 times. So
wow.
It's called A Double Shot of Redemption. It's available on Amazon, but it includes how I went from my heroin addiction to sobriety, to chasing after God, to falling for the deception, how I got out of it, and how I began my recovery. And in the
wow.
back of the book is a resource. I listed every single state, and there's addiction centers, homeless shelters, and food pantries for every single state in the back of the book.
Oh my gosh. Thank you so much. I know the viewers will really be encouraged by your story, and thank you for the resources. If there's one last word of encouragement that you could give to someone who maybe just came to the faith, what would that be?
Pursue truth and don't settle. Consistently and persistently pursue that truth in Jesus Christ, and continually ask Him to shine light into dark areas that's inside of you, but also to sanctify you in that truth so that you can become more like Him. And there is a process of refinement that is difficult, but the outcome is being more like Jesus and freedom. And that's why I also write the book, is because the freedom I got from continuing in my pursuit of God, even after someone deceived me, I wouldn't go back, but I also wouldn't change my story ever.
Amen.
So, yes, just keep persevering, perseverance. Don't give up. Continue to seek Jesus with all your heart. Jesus said, pick up your cross and follow me. Don't look back. Leave the vain conceit. You performed your worship like the concerts of the world. Separate yourselves, cast not your pearl. You worship me with your lips, but your heart is far from me. Your evangelism creates more Christian phonies.
Wow.
Who are you to tell me to heal? Your worship is fake and your heart cries not real. The music and lights give you an emotional high. The people-pleasing performance make me angry inside. In private rooms, do you spend time with me? Have you given up things or followed faithfully? Do you seek my counsel? Do you seek holiness? Are you performing for yourself? Is your character of lowliness? Repent, you know you are nothing without me. Repent and depend, in Christ alone you are complete. By my grace you have been saved. By my grace the path was paved. Do not evangelize without my leading. I'm the one who gives and takes, without your permission preceding. There are none that are good, only the Father in heaven. Why do bad things happen to good people? That's a faulty question. Good people do not exist. We are people with sin, and sin persists. Sin is our nature, and that nature is evil. So the real question is, why do good things happen to bad people? Because of Jesus Christ, he reconciled us to God. Christ cleansed us of our sin because we are flawed. We are not good, no, not even one, but Christ in us, the Father's perfect Son. By him we have faith, by him we can believe, by him we evangelize and worship wholeheartedly. Health and wealth and abundance will leave you deceived, but it's by mercy alone we have received. Those who follow will suffer, those who follow will experience pain, but to live is Christ, and to die is gain.
A weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. When the darkness falls, it won't prevail. Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph.